chapter 1. Today we are going to complete the last topic of the chapter 1, that is macroeconomics, its importance. In the previous lecture we have discussed about the what is macroeconomics, what are its scopes and features. Today we will do the little revision on the previous lecture, as well as we will complete the last topic, that is importance of macroeconomics. In macroeconomic, we have seen that macroeconomic is a study of aggregate, it is a study of a whole. So macroeconomic is also a branch of economics. It is from the formed by the Greek word, that means macros. So macroeconomic studies whole economy, total employment, total consumption, total saving, economic as a whole, economic growth, economic development, economical problems like population, inequalities, unemployment, poverty, aggregate demand, aggregate supply. These are certain topics that macroeconomic cover. So in simple words, we can say that macroeconomic is a study of an whole, is a study of an aggregate. So we can say, we can also say that in simple words, it is an aggregative study, friends. It is an aggregative study. So today we will discuss about the features of macroeconomic. So let's have a small revision on its definition. So that is by J. L. Hasnain. Macroeconomic is that branch of economic which consider the relationship between the large aggregate as in volume of employment, total amount of saving, investment, national income, etc. So the macroeconomic is nothing but in simple words we can say that it is a study of whole aggregate, whereas in microeconomic we have seen that it studies the small individual part or particular part in detail. That same the same opposite of microeconomic is macro. That means when micro studies the small or aggregative part, macro will study about the large and total as in whole aggregative part. So let us discuss its features of microeconomic. Features of macroeconomics. The very first feature is study of aggregates. What does this mean? Its definition, its meaning, its introduction itself says that the macroeconomic will study the economic as a whole, as a totality, as aggregate. So it will study the total employment, total saving, total consumption, aggregate demand, aggregate supply, aggregate output, aggregate of all industries, the total national income, the national output. It will study of the domestic national total domestic income. It will study of economic growth, economic development. It will also study of population in the employment, unemployment, the poverty, all these things it will study as an aggregative study, friends. It will study as in whole. It will study as in totality. It will study as aggregate. So, therefore, the very first feature itself states that it's a study of aggregates. So, it studies the economy as in whole. It studies the economic as an aggregate. So, it study the economic as an aggregative study. The second one is income theory. What does income theory means? The concept of investment, employment, the methods of calculating. So macroeconomic studies the income theory, the concept of national income, its elements, its method, all this comes under the income theory. That means how will the national income be calculated, what are the methods to calculate, what are the elements that has to be considered, what is aggregate demand, aggregate supply, this all comes under the theory of income. That means in simple words, what is national income? National income is the income which is generated within the economical boundaries and the aggregate or the net income from abroad. So this is the national income. So how will this national income be calculated? What are its elements? What are the methods? What are the functions that has to be considered? That it comes, all those things all come under the income theory. Then it is general equilibrium analysis. What does general equilibrium analysis means? General equilibrium means what is the behavior of large aggregates, that is large demand and supply, how they behave, what are the fluctuation, what are the reasons of the prices, the actual price and the equilibrium price. All this are considered under the general equilibrium analysis. So behavior, the behavior relation of the aggregate demand and aggregate supply and the functional relation between them is considered in the general equilibrium analysis. Once again friends, the first one we have studied the study of aggregates, the second one was income theory, the third one was general equilibrium analysis. All these features are overlapping each other because all those are interdependence. The fourth one would be the interdependence. Before starting with the interdependence, I would like you to give you 15-20 seconds to read study of aggregate, income theory, general equilibrium analysis, so that the other features become more easier for you. Then read the page number 5 in which you can see the features of macroeconomic. The first, second, third feature you have to read, understand. If you have doubt, you can ask me in the live session. Study of aggregate, macroeconomic deals with the study of national income as a whole. It studies the very large economic with aggregates such as national output, national income, total employment, aggregate demand, aggregate supply, total investment, total consumption, general price level, etc. Then it was income theory. Macroeconomic is also known as the theory of income, employment, or similarly income analysis, because the subject matter of macroeconomic analysis explains what determines the level of national income, its elements, methods, its aggregate demand, aggregate supply, or what are the causes and fluctuation in them, and also explains the growth of national income over the long period of time. General equilibrium analysis, the third one was general equilibrium analysis. That means macroeconomic analysis is based on general equilibrium analysis. This analysis deals with the entire economy in the context of equilibrium. It studies the behavior and number of economic variables at time and takes into consideration their functional relation and interdependence. In doing so, the approach assumes everything depends on everything else, which we are going to study in interdependence. In simple words, we can say that general equilibrium analysis is the behavior of how aggregate, large aggregate and the functional relationship of like aggregate demand and aggregate supply will behave. What are the causes? What are the fluctuation? The in actual price and equilibrium price, that would be considered in general equilibrium analysis. Hope so. The three features of macroeconomic is very clear. First one was study of aggregate. Second one was income theory. Third one was general equilibrium analysis. Let's see the fourth one. Fourth one is, the fourth one is interdependence. What does interdependence means? Each element or each variable in macroeconomic, what are the variable of macroeconomic students? Aggregate demand, aggregate supply, total output, national income, total consumption, poverty, unemployment, inequality, those are the variables of macroeconomic. So all those variables are interdependent on each other. What does this mean? That means one variable will depend on other, the other would be dependent on it or something else. For example, when we are talking about interdependence between aggregate variable, such as when we are talking about the national income, so national income will be depend upon the employments, how many the employments are there in the country, and the employment will be dependent upon the investment. So the income or income will be dependent upon the investment. So all these factors, like total as in whole and aggregates, are interdependent on each other. Suppose, for example, once again, let me explain you, the income, the employment would depend upon the income. Income would depend upon the investment. Investment will depend upon the demand and the supply of that particular commodity. So all those are interdependent variables. So macroeconomic, we can say that one depend upon the other. So it has an interdependence between the economic variables. Then it use lumping method. Also, you remember in microeconomic, we see that microeconomic use slicing method. Same way, macroeconomic use lumping method. The word lumping means it will study as in lump sum. It will study as in whole, as an aggregate. When we are talking about the national income, so it is talking about the national income of the country as in whole, as an aggregate. So it will use the lumping method because the definition features meaning itself says that it will study as an aggregate, it will study as in whole, it will study as in totality. So that means it will use the lumping method, which means it will study the economic as in whole or aggregate. It will not see as in particular or individual. When we are using the example, when we are talking about the trees in the forest, we will consider as in whole forest. It will study as in whole forest. It will not study an individual tree in that forest. It will study all the trees of the forest. So it used which method? Lumping method. Once again, the first one was a study of aggregate. Second one was income theory. Third one was general equilibrium analysis. The fourth one was interdependence. Fifth one was lumping method. The sixth one is growth model. What does this mean? Macroeconomic depends upon the growth model. It sees the growth model. How the national income is changing, increasing. What are the factors which will give economic growth and development? What are the things which has to be followed for economic growth? So it will see the growth model to see that the country economic growth and development occurs. What are the things, what are the models it has to be built or it has to be find out to have a growth and development in a country. So the sixth one was growth model. The seventh one is general price level. What does this mean, general price level? General price level means what are the prices which occurs the fluctuation in in aggregate demand, in aggregate supply. What are the averages of all the prices what are the average price of the goods and service will be considered in the general price level. In general price level, it will generally study the aggregate price of the commodity or of the goods and service, the whole prices of the goods and service. Then the last one is policy oriented. What does this mean? Policy oriented, for the economic growth and development, it will orient the policies, it will firm the policies, follow those policies so that a country as a whole, as a totality, it should grow, it should develop. So it will depend upon, it will see the policy oriented. Once again, the first one was study of aggregates, income theory, general equilibrium analysis, interdependence, lumping method, growth model, the general price level, and the last one is policy oriented. Friends, once again I will give you 20 seconds to read 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th point so that your points get clear. Then we'll have a small and quick revision once again on the feature. Then we will go towards the importance of macroeconomy. Before starting with an importance, let's have a small revision once again. 20 seconds for last 4 points. Read it, understand it. In interdependence, macroeconomics takes into an account of interdependence between income, output, employment, investment, price level. For example, change in the level of investment will finally result into the change in the level of income, level of output, employment, eventually the level of growth. In simple way, we can say that the approach assumes everything depends on everything else. What does interdependence means? This approach assumes that everything will depend on the everything else. Since the approach deals with the whole economy, it has explains how aggregate supply, aggregate demand brought into inequality, how equilibrium between these forces determine not only the price level but also the level of income and employment. The whole analysis involves the study of number of variables and their interdependence or interaction. Then it uses lumping method, deals with the behavior of aggregate, that is total value of economic variable related to whole economy. It uses the lumping to deals with macroeconomic variables such as aggregate demand, aggregate supply, national output, etc. Then then it talks about growth model. What does growth model means? The growth model means it studies the various factors that contribute towards economic growth and development. It is useful for developing growth model. Growth models are used for studying economic development of the country. Then general price level. Determination is based on the general equilibrium analysis, general price level. The general price level studies the macroeconomic. General price level is the average of all the prices of goods and services currently produced in the economy. Policy oriented, according to Keynes, macroeconomic is the policy oriented science. It studies the suitable, it suggests the suitable economic policies to promote economic growth and generate employment, control inflation and depression, etc. The last topic that we are going to see is importance of macroeconomic. Hope so, all the features
are very clear.
The very first feature was study of aggregate, income theory, general criterion analysis, interdependence, lumping method, growth model, general price level, policy oriented. Hope so you have very cleared with all this 8 features of macroeconomics. Let me tell you kids, micro is by studying macro, it will consider micro also, because all individual are gathered collectively, it is said to be a macroeconomics. So in micro we used to study individual or small or particular part. In macro we will study all the individual part together as a whole, as a totality, as an aggregate. So very first feature was study of aggregates, income theory, general equilibrium analysis, interdependence, lumping method, growth model, general price level, policy oriented. Then we'll start with an importance. Let's have a read on page number 5. Then we'll start with an importance. After discussing with the features, let's have a revision on the let's discuss the importance of macroeconomics. Friends, the importance of macroeconomics, as microeconomics is also important to us, so many places, like for business decision, for producer, for consumer, for foreign trade, to understand the things, economic model building, and so on. Same way, macroeconomics are also important to many places. Like very first place is functioning, to understand the functioning of an economy. So macroeconomic helps to understand the functioning of economic. How does functioning of economy it helps? It gives an idea how does the economic function, what helps us to understand the behavior pattern of large aggregate and output. Once again, functioning of economic, macroeconomic gives an idea how does the economic function, or how does the economic functions, and how it helps to understand the behavior pattern of large and complex economic. So what it is saying, the very first function here, very first important is functioning of economic. In functioning of economic, with the help of macroeconomic, it helps to understand how does economic functions, and it also helps to give an idea to understand the behavior pattern of the large aggregate and complex economic. The second one was economic fluctuation. With the help of macroeconomic, what are the economic fluctuation? What are the causes to fluctuate in total output, employment, poverty, the income, output, employment, investment? So with the study of macroeconomic, it helps us to understand the economic fluctuation. What are the causes to have an economic fluctuation? Fluctuation in output, like a fluctuation in income, in employment, in investment. So with the help of macroeconomic, it helps to understand the economic fluctuations. Then national income, with the help of macroeconomic study, it helps us to understand the national income. Let me tell you friends, with the help of macroeconomic, it becomes easier to calculate national income, because national without the help of calculating national income, it is not possible that how much a country is growing or developing, we cannot find out. So macroeconomic helps to find out the national income of the country, and also dealing with the accounting, social accounting. Macroeconomic also helps to understand the national income. With the help of national income only, we can say how much the country is growing or developing. The fourth one I would say is it helps in economic development. With the help of finding out the national income, it development, what are the policies it required to stimulate the economic development, what are the advanced study it has to deal for economic development, which areas it required for development, what are the sources, what are the policy is required for economic development. These all are the where macroeconomic helps for the doing the function. The very first one was functioning of economic, second one was economic fluctuation, third one was national income, fourth one was economic development. Again, some time to read, understand. If you have doubt, ask me in the live session. Last three function importance of macroeconomics are left. Before that, I will give you time to understand all the four. Read and understand what is the thing, and then we will discuss about the further topics of importance of macroeconomics. Functioning of economy, economic fluctuation, national income, economic development are these some of the importance of macroeconomic. In functioning of economic, macroeconomic analysis gives idea of functioning of economic system. It helps us to understand and behavior and of aggregate variables of large and complex economic system. Economic fluctuation, macroeconomic helps to analyze the causes of fluctuation in economic output, employment, and makes an attempt to control them to reduce their problems. National income, study of macroeconomic has brought forward to emerge importance of study of national income and social accounting. Without the study of national income, it is not possible to formulate the correct economic policies. Then economic development, advanced studies in macroeconomic help to understand the problem for developing countries, such as poverty, inequalities, unemployment, population, income and wealth, difference in the standard of living of people, etc. It suggests important steps to achieve economic development. So these were the four importance of macroeconomic. The first one, once again, functioning of economy. Second one, economic fluctuation. Third one was national income. Fourth one was economic development. Let's discuss the fifth one, performance of economics. Performance of an economy. With the help of macroeconomic, it helps us to understand how much goods and service has been produced for that particular year. With the help of the goods and service produced within the particular year will help us to estimate the national income, and it will give us help us to compare between the previous year and the current year. So the performance of economy, in the performance economic, it help us to understand how much goods has been produced and what is the national income. It helps us to estimate them as well as to perform how the country is performing with the help of the performance of economic. Then it is study of macroeconomic variables. What are the variables of macroeconomic? population, unemployment. These are the certain variables of macroeconomic, which with the help of this aggregate studies and total, as a study of whole, as a study of total, it helps us to understand the study of macroeconomic variables. And the last one is level of employment. What does the level of employment means? The level of employment, what are the reasons for fluctuation in employment? What are the reasons for the economic, for increase in employment or decrease in employment? What is the level of employment, so that it helps us to understand GNP. So, these were the functions of macroeconomic. First one was national functioning of economic. Economic fluctuation, national income, economic development, performance of an economic, study of economic variable, level of employment. These are the certain functions that we have discussed. Here we end with our chapter 1, that is introduction to micro and macro. Next chapter would be consumer behavior or utility analysis. It's a very good chapter, interesting too. Let's have a small revision on the today's topic that we have covered. We have seen the features. In feature, we have seen the study of aggregate, income theory, general price equilibrium analysis, interdependence, clumping method, growth model, general price level, policy oriented. Then we have discussed about the importance. In importance, we have seen the functioning of economic fluctuation, national income, economic development, performance of an economy, study of macroeconomic variable, employment level. Here we end with our chapter 1, that is introduction of micro and macro. Before ending towards this session, it's a request to read what has been taught to you, because without reading it will become difficult. After reading you have to even write, then only you can be ready for your board exam. It will be long lasting be in your memories. The topics would be long lasting in your memories. So read and then write.